Is it possible that deep within the Bible lays a code hidden until the end of the age? Today, Jonathan talks with an investigative reporter and a prophecy expert who claim there is a conspiracy underway to create a global government and cashless society. Was this predicted by the prophets of the Old Testament thousands of years ago? How will this affect you, and what can you do about it? Just ahead on Jewish Voice.
Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, a program to help you to understand the Jewish roots of your Christian faith, Bible prophecy, and world events surrounding Israel. Did the prophets actually predict the creation of a global government, a one-world religion and economic system? And if so, are these initiatives already underway? And if they are, how far along are they? Are end-time signs predicted by Jesus and the prophets actually being fulfilled around us? Today, a prophecy expert and an investigative journalist who spent 5 years answering these questions are with us, and they say that they can link current events and secret societies with Bible prophecy. Please welcome back to the program the authors of The Babylon Code, Paul McGuire and Troy Anderson. Gentlemen, let me jump right in. Is there a link? Do you see a link between Bible prophecy and the predictions that Jesus himself being made with what's happening today? Whoever wants to start.
Absolutely, because Jesus talked about the signs of the times, as you know, Jonathan, and one of the pinnacles of these signs of the times is a global religion, a global government, and a global economic system. And God also speaks to us about that in the book of Genesis.
So where specifically?
In Genesis, it talks about the story of the Tower of Babel and Nimrod. He's an archetype of the Antichrist. He oversees the first world government. And then Babylon plays a central role in the books of the prophets and then reemerges as mystery Babylon in the book of Revelation. And so that's what we dig into is what is mystery Babylon? You know, over the decades, there's been theories, you know, maybe it's the European Union or it's Rome or it's the United States. And so we try to unpack exactly what is mystery Babylon and Babylon the Great.
All right, so, and then Troy, you gave us in yesterday's program some staggering statistics. One that comes to mind is that 50, and this is a secular poll that done by the University of Chicago, 51% of Americans say there's a secret cabal that's running our country.
Yeah, this was one of the most surprising things in our research into this book. You know, we did over 100 interviews, read hundreds of books, thousands of pages of documents, but this one survey by the University of Chicago, you know, they asked various questions, and one of them was, you know, who really runs things? And 51% of Americans said a so-called secret cabal. And then, you know, much of the research we did also found that, you know, there is some kind of, you know, behind the scenes power structure beyond just the figureheads that we see in office.
84%, you mentioned to me, believe that there's an imminent attack that will take place on American soil by ISIS.
Yeah, there was 84% of Americans believe that, you know, ISIS is you know, in the near future is probably going to be attacking inside the United States. And so we take a big picture look at all these different things and link it all together.
As we continue from yesterday, one world religion, one world government, and one world economic system. Paul, you believe this is already well underway.
Absolutely. With the creation of the United Nations around 1945, and I'm not saying the UN is the global government, but it's acting kind of like a global government. The idea for global government came out in the open with the legitimate hope that a one world government would give us peace. We wouldn't have wars because we wouldn't have independent nations fighting one another. But the danger of a global government is clearly warned about by God. Going back into Genesis, Nimrod, the founder of the global government in Babylon, is a type of the Antichrist. And as you know, when you read the book of Revelation, you see Babylon returns and who runs Babylon but the false prophet and the Antichrist. So Christians need to be very concerned about all this promotion of globalism.
Okay, but let's talk about reality. What we see now on the world scene. Troy, you're a journalist. We have Russia moving their pieces into place in the Middle East. We have tension between Russia and America, China and America, China and Russia. Everyone's tense with North Korea. I mean, we seem to be growing further away from a one-world government and peace.
Yeah, what we talk about in the book is that, you know, for many decades now, there's been something what one politician refers to as the plan. And so that there's a long-term, you know, step-by-step process that the elite are using to put the system into place. And so we see, you know, through globalism and like the recent United Nations Sustainable Development Summit and the Global Citizen Festival they held in New York City, where, you know, they had all kinds of celebrities and musicians that came. And so there's a concerted campaign to get us to think of as ourselves as global citizens and, you know, bringing the world together. So even though we still have nation states, there's this move to sort of, you know, bring it all together through international treaties and laws and different things.
So do you believe there's actual groups that are architecting these steps? Staged steps, Russia moving into Ukraine, the developments in Iran. Are these things all being planned out, do you believe? How far did we go with
this? Yes, we do believe that to a large degree, not to a total degree, but to a large degree. So, for example, you talked about Russia and the Ukraine and Russia going into Syria. Well, there's a game being played, and that game is called the Hegelian dialectic, which we go into in the book, The Babylon Code, and that is you raise up two opposites. So you have Russia, a military threat, and then you have ISIS in the Middle East, and then you have America. And the game plan is that you terrify people with two opposites to bring about a predetermined outcome or middle path. So the middle path is disarm the various nations, including Russia and the United States, no longer have, quote, superpowers, and you can have a peaceful global government enforced by a one-world planetary police force, like the blue-helmeted UN police.
Okay, so are you seeing a move towards a one-world government now with cooperation from the various nation states, from various countries?
With lightning speed.
Talk about some of the groups that you believe are involved in this. Obviously, we know who the architect is, the evil one, but some of the groups involved. Troy?
Yeah. So some of the interconnected organizations, everything from the Council on Foreign Relations to the Bilderberg Group, Bohemian Grove, Skull and Bones, you know, even the World Bank, you know, different intelligence agencies, MI6, the CIA, that there's sort of this interconnected system that's all put together by the wealthy elite that, you know, is helping put this whole system into place. And now it's important to note that the Bible says that this whole system won't actually go into place until, you know, most likely the latter half of the tribulation period. So there'll probably be some, you know, great crisis, either an economic crisis or a war that'll help, you know, facilitate the rise of the system during the tribulation.
Everyone loves a good conspiracy. We have to take a quick break. When we return, lots more with authors Paul McGuire and Troy Anderson. Stay with us.
Here at Jewish Voice, we are dedicated to proclaiming Jesus, the Messiah, to the world, to the Jew first, and also to the nations. One key way we do this is by providing life-saving humanitarian aid to some of the poorest people in the world. In helping them, we share God's love and the good news of Yeshua, Jesus. Today, we are urgently preparing for our next medical clinic to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Barangwa, Zimbabwe, the Lemba. This faithful yet forgotten people have ties to the ancient people of Israel, the priestly tribe of Aaron, and have been practicing ancient Jewish customs for hundreds of years. We need your help to make this vital life-saving outreach possible. Will you be a blessing to these wonderful people and the thousands of others in desperate need? The elderly, children, infants, and toddlers could die for lack of basic medical care. You can help save lives, but we must act now. Call or click right now to help us save lives. And with your gift of any amount, we'll say thank you by sending you a new book by prophecy expert Paul McGuire and journalist Troy Anderson, The Babylon Code, Solving the Bible's Greatest End Times Mystery. This book investigates a topic most end times resources don't: the link between secret societies, Bible prophecy, and current events.
It also reveals how powerful forces are currently at work right now to create a global government, one religion, and a cashless society. This powerful book may very well hold the secret to your survival and salvation. You'll also receive this informative 2-CD set by Rabbi Jonathan Bernis called The Role of Israel in Last Days Prophecy. This in-depth teaching series looks at the pivotal role Israel plays in end times events and answers questions such as, are we in the last days? And what one single great event must take place before the return of Jesus? If God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $120 or more today to help some of the neediest people on earth, we'll send you all of the gifts just mentioned and a set of 3 Jerusalem Globe candle holders with silver and gold finishes. This lovely and unique set includes 1 large and 2 small candle holders, all featuring significant Jerusalem landmarks. They are sure to remind you to pray for the Jewish people and the peace of Jerusalem. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people, to share a gift in support of this humanitarian aid, and to help countless others around the globe. Please call or click now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the neediest people on earth. Once again, time is of the essence for many of these people. Please call or click right now.
We're back with authors Paul McGuire and Troy Anderson, who've written a book called The Babylon Code. And this is a 5-year project, you guys, linking global events, prophecy, and secret organizations. Paul, why the Babylon Code? I remember various books on codes, things that were found in between the pages of the Bible, the sentences of the Bible, looking at the Hebrew and so on. What does this mean, the Babylon Code?
Well, our term, the Babylon Code, is very straightforward, so it's no monkey business with the word stuff. It simply means that if you go back and study God's word, the original building of Babylon, God put a powerful message of warning to his people in that account of Babylon. Because that account of Babylon, which sadly to say is not taught very much anymore, God gives us a warning about a coming one world government, one world religion, and one world economic system. I mean, it's the inspired, inerrant word of God. It's a flashing light. And here we are in our lifetime, thousands of years later, and this very same Babylon is reemerging in our lifetime. And I don't know about you, that kind of makes my boots shake a little bit because it's Bible prophecy coming alive.
Troy, interestingly, you're a journalist who worked for many secular publications. You're the editor of Charisma now. You actually did 100-plus interviews with people and asked them, well-known figures, and asked them, are we in the last days? And they weren't just Christians. Talk about that.
So I interviewed everybody from, you know, Billy Graham to Dr. Tim LaHaye to Hal Lindsey to Rabbi Jonathan Kahn, Mark Hitchcock, Greg Laurie. And then and the consensus among all these, you know, Bible prophecy experts and faith leaders is, yes, we're in the run-up to the end-time events predicted in the Bible. But the most surprising thing was we interviewed secular experts. We interviewed Noam Chomsky and professors at Princeton and different prestigious universities and institutes that actually studied the potential end of human civilization. And the consensus on the secular side is that we're in the run-up to the end of human civilization, and they're trying to figure out what could be done to stop it from happening.
That's fascinating to me. Now, Paul, let's talk about one group that you mentioned. There's a number of different groups, but one you mentioned in the book, the Illuminati, because they go back a long ways, and we were warned by some very prominent American figures to be aware of the Illuminati. Who are the Illuminati, and who warned us about the Illuminati?
Well, as we document in the book, The Babylon Code, our founding fathers warned us about the Illuminati. George Washington warned about the Illuminati by name. So did Hamilton. So did Thomas Jefferson. The spiritual father of the first great awakening, Jonathan Edwards, his grandson, was the head of one of the Ivy League schools. He preached a powerful sermon warning of the Illuminati by name. So it's only relatively recently that modern Christians, sadly, have dismissed the reality of the Illuminati theory, of the Illuminati, as being kind of a conspiracy
theory. So who are they? Who were they? Who are they?
They are the Illumined Ones. They are a group that has migrated of secret societies starting from ancient Babylon. They became the Rosicrucians in Europe, and then they morphed into the Illuminati, oddly enough, in 1776, and they remain with us today. In fact, if people are skeptical, they can flip over the back of their U.S. dollar on a $1 bill. They'll see an Illuminati pyramid with the all-seeing eye of Lucifer, and if that's not enough, the words from Latin, Nuvos Order Seclorum, New Order of the Ages, which means New World Order.
So how do, and they're after One World Order?
Yes.
For, and they've been working on it for hundreds of years, thousands of years now.
Years. Yes.
Thousands of years. So, and you believe that they connect with other organizations, or this is a demonic effort, a demonic plot that somehow uses these various groups?
Both. And they work with other organizations. They interface with numerous globalist organizations.
Okay, so we talked a little bit about government. Talk about a movement towards one religion, one world religion. Certainly not Christianity. It's certainly not Judaism.
Correct. And what we're seeing in our lifetime, like no other lifetime, there is a war on any belief system, Judaism, Christianity, any belief system that dares to say that they have the truth. Jesus Christ said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but through me. But the Illuminati and these other groups, they are perpetuating the lie that there are many paths to God. Now, I know this is going to be hard for a lot of people to swallow, but ultimately that's because they're Luciferian in nature. And I know that's a hard road for a lot of people to embrace, but we document it in the book. The founders of the Illuminati, the thinkers in the Illuminati, they subscribe, by their own words and documents, they subscribe to what you and I would call Luciferian beliefs.
Troy, examples?
In the third chapter, we talk about how we sort of came together to write this book. And one of my ancestors is Friedrich von Schiller. He's the German poet and playwright who wrote Ode to Joy that Beethoven set to music in the Ninth Symphony. In the late 1700s, all his friends were members of the original Bavarian Illuminati. And then he later on sort of became wise to what was happening, and towards the end of his life wrote a play to expose them, and then he died mysteriously. So, you know, in a way we're sort of, you know, picking up where he left off and then investigating this great mystery that, you know, has connections to ancient Babylon and what's happening today.
So now we just have a minute left. We'll have you back tomorrow, but give us the there's an answer here. There's good news here. In the midst of all of the conspiracy and the demonic plots, there's good news.
There's great news. And the great news is that Babylon, let's say, according to God, is the city of man. It's the city of Luciferian beliefs. But Jerusalem is the city of God. And the Messiah, the real Messiah, is going to come back to Jerusalem to establish a new heaven and a new earth, and to deliver his bride, both Jews that believe in the Messiah and Christians. And I don't know about you, well, I do know about you. That, to me, that's a cause for holy celebration and rejoicing.
If you want to understand it, you've got to get the book. We just scratched the surface. It's all the time we have for today. And Paul and Troy will be back tomorrow. And we hope you will too. Their book, The Babylon Code, is shocking. It's fascinating. You won't be able to put it down, and we want to make it available to you on this program today. You need to be wise. You need to know what's going on, because you're part of the solution. There's lots more ahead. We'll be right back.
The Lemba, a lost tribe of Israel, discovered in the remote regions of Zimbabwe. DNA proves that they are descendants of the priestly tribe of Aaron. Practicing their Jewish faith for thousands of years, not knowing their long-awaited Messiah has come and will come again. And the Jewish Voice Outreach Team has the privilege of sharing this amazing good news with them through our outreaches in Zimbabwe. It's amazing. Come witness this miracle. Be an important part of God at work in these last days, gathering His people back to Himself. We need volunteers urgently for this outreach, medical professionals, prayer partners, and practical service volunteers, as we minister to thousands of very needy and spiritually hungry people in just one short week. Come with us and help these desperate Jewish people. Say yes to being God's hands and feet. Please answer the call.
For the last 4 years, we've been reaching out to a community in the remote bush of Zimbabwe known as the Lemba. In fact, we go all over the world to provide medical aid and clean water to those who desperately need it. The Lemba, even though they have been isolated in the remote bush of Zimbabwe, have been keeping Jewish traditions for centuries. Now, with the help of many of you, we're providing free medical care and, most importantly, the gospel. Many are coming to know the Lord. Take a look.
In one of the most remote areas of southern Zimbabwe, a team of 51 volunteers were joined by 120 national workers. And together, they just finished one of the most challenging and rewarding Jewish Voice outreaches to date. In a week full of both work and ministry, the Lord's hand was clearly seen as Jewish Voice conducted its very first medical outreach to the impoverished Lemba Jewish community.
We've seen children who couldn't speak, they couldn't hear, they couldn't do anything. I'm shocked. And then they can speak, and they can hear, and they can say their names. Babies that there was this 18-month-old baby that couldn't even stand up or sit up, nothing. And then it had witchcraft bracelets on its wrist. They were cut off, and the baby sat up immediately. I mean. eyes to see with adults. I've seen so many miracles. My heart is just filling up. I'm forever going to be changed over this entire experience. It's the best thing that has ever happened to me.
In the afternoon, I was starting to feel pretty tired. My compassion level for patients was dropping. And all of a sudden, the nurse came into my room and said, "Can you see this patient outside?" And I said, feeling tired, "Well, can't they carry the patient into my room?" And she's like, "Well, she looks pretty sick." So I went outside, and I go up to this cart that is being drawn by two donkeys, near death look on this young female who is dying from AIDS. And I find out that she's come 8 kilometers to seek help. And it was kind of like a slap upside my head, because 2 minutes before that, I'm in my room feeling sorry for myself. And that was just God saying, "How do you feel now?" And I didn't know what to do. I see a dying woman and I can't help her. But as a man of God, I can share love, I can show compassion. And that's not easy for me to do, but God working through me made it very easy.
The Lord is looking down on this with favor, and he's looking down on this that he loves culture and he loves diversity. And I had such a warm, wonderful feeling that the Lemba here are very gentle and loving people, and that the Lord has not forgotten them, and that they have retained as much as they possibly can of their culture and of their Jewishness.
Zimbabwe, Ethiopia, India, outposts around the world where Jewish people and their neighbors need our help. That's where we go, bearing witness of Jesus, restoring hope, and transforming lives. And if you come with us on a medical outreach, your life will be changed forever. Now, there's a cost involved, but believe me, it will be worth every dollar. If you feel called to join us on one of our upcoming outreaches in 2016, you can call the number on your screen or go to jewishvoice.com. jewishvoice.tv.
Here at Jewish Voice, we are dedicated to proclaiming Jesus, the Messiah, to the world, to the Jew first, and also to the nations. One key way we do this is by providing life-saving humanitarian aid to some of the poorest people in the world. In helping them, we share God's love and the good news of Yeshua, Jesus. Today, we are urgently preparing for our next medical clinic to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Barangwa, Zimbabwe, the Lemba. This faithful yet forgotten people have ties to the ancient people of Israel, the priestly tribe of Aaron, and have been practicing ancient Jewish customs for hundreds of years. We need your help to make this vital life-saving outreach possible. Will you be a blessing to these wonderful people and the thousands of others in desperate need? The elderly, children, infants, and toddlers could die for lack of basic medical care. You can help save lives, but we must act now. Call or click right now to help us save lives. And with your gift of any amount, we'll say thank you by sending you a new book by prophecy expert Paul McGuire and journalist Troy Anderson, The Babylon Code, Solving the Bible's Greatest End Times Mystery. This book investigates a topic most end times resources don't, the link between secret societies, Bible prophecy, and current events. It also reveals how powerful forces are currently at work right now to create a global government, one religion, and a cashless society. This powerful book may very well hold the secret to your survival and salvation. You'll also receive this informative 2-CD set by Rabbi Jonathan Bernis called The Role of Israel in Last Days Prophecy. This in-depth teaching series looks at the pivotal role Israel plays in end times events and answers questions such as, are we in the last days? And what one single great event must take place before the return of Jesus? If God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $120 or more today to help some of the neediest people on earth, we'll send you all of the gifts just mentioned and a set of three Jerusalem Globe candle holders with silver and gold finishes. This lovely and unique set includes one large and two small candle holders, all featuring significant Jerusalem landmarks. They are sure to remind you to pray for the Jewish people and the peace of Jerusalem. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people, to share a gift in support of this humanitarian aid, and to help countless others around the globe. Please call or click now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the neediest people on earth. Once again, time is of the essence for many of these people. Please call or click right now.
I want to thank you for watching today, and I hope you'll join us again tomorrow as I continue talking with the authors of The Babylon Code, Paul McGuire and Troy Anderson. Remember, till next time, to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. According to Psalm 122:6, they need your prayers now more than ever. Until next time, I'm Jonathan Bernis saying shalom and God bless you.